I'm not in a hurry to go back to America. I have options. I could even transfer online to do my studies. George Weah did the same thing, even though he learned nothing in the classroom.
That's true.
Because he's a very dull man. And get on the record. Get on the record. If they want me in Liberia, I will be in Liberia. And they better get ready for my tension. If they want to arrest me, let them come arrest me. But the main reason why we are here, that was nothing. You may not be aware, the government of Liberia, George Weah, has instructed that nine of your oil blocks, be sold in one big round. Nine oil blocks be sold in one big round. And we have received credible information that of those nine oil blocks, Mr. Weah has 50% share in two of them. Go and Google it. www.worldoil.com. Google it. Liberia to sell nine oil blocks. Just put it in Google. They are about to sell nine of your country's oil blocks. Quietly. Have they made any public pronouncement about it?
No.
They don't intend to. The COP wishes to inform you that we will begin to hold a series of mass meetings this week to review our earlier pronouncement of the suspension of protest activities so that we can reactivate our operations to resist any attempt by this government to banjo away nine of our oil blocks. We will not let that happen. The next protest will be about oil.
Yes.
It will be an oil protest. And not less in passé. Because I am here. Toria wants me here, I am here. So I can see him every other day and see how he steals and how he conducts himself. But I want to let you know, tomorrow morning I will be on the Costa show also. Uh-huh. So since they want me here now, I will be here. So we can fight together. I said this to you, to our international friends, to the Interreligious Council, Liberal Council of Churches, and all the interventionists. We appreciate your efforts, but it appears to us that you have an insincere partner in the government. The government is not interested in peace. After our peaceful protest, which was violently dispersed by the government, the COP conducted itself in a magnanimous fashion. We suspended all protest activities until otherwise order. The government thinks it's a sign of weakness. John F. Kennedy says, civility is not a sign of weakness. So we want to let the government know that we still have what it takes to put thousands on the streets in this town. And we are reviewing our position on that. Also, I want to inform you that as the Independent National Human Rights Commission stated in their report, there are very nefarious elements working for Nathaniel McGill. Ofori Dia, you all members of the president, be very careful with these people. Colonel Joseph Nangbe, Augustine Nangbe, aka General Powell, CFR Nomo. And the man who coordinates all these activities for Nathaniel McGill is the deputy NSA boss, Sam Sion. Sam Sion, I want to put this information out there as a public announcement. Sam Sion is running a terror ring in this town. He is extorting money from business people, intimidating them, harassing them, shaking people down, and he reports to Nathaniel McGill. I also have credible information that on the day of our peaceful protest, it was Sam Sion who gave the orders that we be moved on by directive of the president. Those were his exact words. I want you all to know, report it, Sam Sion, deputy NSA boss. He is a terrorist. He is terrorizing people in this town, shaking people down, extorting money from people, and frightening them. We want to let them know that we are prepared. If they want to kill us, our chests are exposed. You don't see me wearing a bulletproof vest. We are in this town, and we are not afraid. The COP will be getting back to you shortly, on our next course of action in the next couple of days. Thank you very much. At this point, I would like to stop here, and we'll take four questions only.
I wanted to add, expanding on the point that Costa put forward very forcefully, the laissez-passer that was presented at the airport, as far as the LRS is concerned, was invalid laissez-passer.
Yes.
We do not know where people on social media have taken fake laissez-passer from. This GOL received from Henry Pedro Costa on the 19th of December a valid travel certificate. The COP stands by Costa. We looked into the case. We know that Henry Costa presented a valid. That is the only reason why a trained immigration officer would admit him without alarm. That's the point I want to clarify.
Yes.
Yes.
The laissez-passer that was presented to me yesterday by the immigration boss has been forced. It's not the same laissez-passer I presented to them at the airport. Yes. Take note of that. It is not the same laissez-passer. They have the original. They let me in on it after they scanned it, and it was validated. The one that was presented to me is not the one I presented to them. That is a lie. It was forced by George Weah, he and his people, and his girlfriend, the deputy immigration boss for operations, Abigail Wiese. George Weah's girlfriend, deputy immigration boss, she forged the document. It is not my lesson per se. Let's take the four questions and close up.
Yes, Arthur Rosier from the Daily Observer newspaper. Costa, is this the first time for you using lesson per se?
No, sir. I have used it before.
And secondly, a government does not prove anything in its point. Are you prepared to take them to task?
I am not prepared to take them to task. Let them take me to task. We are focusing on the 9 oil blocks that we are wants to sell.
Yes.
Let them sue me for lesson per se.
Okay, Costa, my name is Emmanuel Kotri from Spoon TV. I want to know, you are talking about you not taking the government to tax on this issue. What do you make of your flight cancellation?
Well, I will leave when I want to leave. But right now, I'm not in any hurry to leave. I am here. Thank you.
Costa, I'm Ronald George from Smart News, like you're online. You just told us that it was an instruction that came from Deputy NSA Director Sam Sayo to disperse the car instead of the national the NMP boss. So how can you compromise these two statements coming from you?
I just told you we have credible sources. That's what I told you. Sam Sayo was on the day of he was there on the scene. He was the one heard shouting the orders. A directive of the president. Move in on the protesters. Sam Sayo is responsible. Besides, he's a terrorist. A state-sponsored terrorist using the apparatus of the state security paraphernalia. Thank you very much. The third question.
Yeah. My name is S. Anyele Kareko for Pro National Policy. My name is Protest.
Nine
blocks.
Mass meetings first.
Yeah.
COP will begin to conduct mass meetings first across communities. Thank you very much. The third question.
Yeah. My name is S. Anyele Kareko for Pro National Policy. My name is Protest. Nine blocks.
Mass meetings first.
Yeah.
COP will begin to conduct mass meetings first across communities. We will begin to do that, and when we feel the time is right, we will make the pronouncement for the next protest.
And let me add on the follow-up.
Hello,
let me add up that protests on this oil issue will be more directed at the legislature, because these are the looters who sit up there and agree to everything the president says.
They will have to ratify it.
They will have to ratify it. They are our representative. We direct our anger to them. We direct the people to them to express the anger at them and to stop whatever ratification that will be submitted to them.
Okay. Are you going to sit in at the legislature?
Would I expose our strategy?
Would I expose our strategy?
Okay. Yes, sir. I'm report for WAP TV Liberia. Having speaking of the issue of the 25 million dollars, and now you are coming forward with our issues, you are not getting any positive result from the essence of the money that God placed in, according to you guys. And now coming out with our issues, are you going to yield a result this time around?
Let me ask you a question.
Who told you Article 17, right, is every time you exercise it, you must wait until you get results before you can exercise it again? It does not work that way.
Exercise it.
Hey, hold on. Article 17 is not a right that is contingent on the fruition of an action, and then you wait until that action succeeds or bears fruit before you can exercise it again. No, you can continuously exercise. That is the reason why the Constitution does not say when you protest for all black, you must wait until you get resolved before you protest for chicken air, wait and get resolved before you protest for this. No, it does not work that way. You have the right to continuously exercise Article 17. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, folks. Have yourselves a wonderful day and look forward to our next press conference. When will we be announcing the date for the next protest?
Thank you. The voice of Karen Petro Costa.